Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 4th of February. Opposition asks Indian government to stop monologue, start dialogue with protesting farmers. Pentagon says no decision yet on future force posture in Afghanistan. A nationwide strike against PM Oli paralyzes Nepal, several arrested. And now for all the details. The opposition parties on Thursday tore into the government in the Indian Parliament for its handling of the ongoing farmers' protest against three new contentious farm laws. Lawmakers said ministers should end monologue and start dialogue, and slammed the government for heavy barricading with the barbed wires and spikes to block protesting farmers from entering into the national capital. Opposition parties on Thursday slammed Prime Minister Narendra Modi-led government in the Indian Parliament for its handling of the ongoing farmers' protests against new agriculture reforms, saying ministers should end monologue and start dialogue. Speaking during the budget session, leaders of opposition parties, including the Trinamool Congress and the Rashtriya Janata Dal, said the government should have built bridges to win over the farmers instead of digging trenches and putting up spikes at the protest sites where they have been camping against the three farm laws since last November.
अरे सरकारें पुल बनाने के लिए लाई जाती हैं, चाहे नदियों पर पुल हो या रिश्तों का पुल हो, आपने तो पुल के बदले दीवारें खड़ी कर दी, वो भी कटीली.
Earlier in the day, a delegation of 15 opposition parliamentarians also visited the Ghazipur border on the outskirts of the Indian capital to meet the protesting farmers. But soon after they reached, they were stopped by the police. The police have stepped up deployment and set up rows of barricades, barbed wire fences and spikes on the roads to prevent the protesting farmers camping at New Delhi's border points from forcing their way into the national capital. The move came after violent clashes during a farmers' tractor rally on January 26. In news from Pakistan, the ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf legislature Farooq Habib has claimed that former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif's PMLN party conceded before the scrutiny committee of the Election Commission that it had received funds from Al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden. The scrutiny committee had summoned PMLN and PPP leaders in the foreign funding case.
The ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf legislator and petitioner in foreign funding cases in the Election Commission of Pakistan, Farooq Habib, said on Wednesday that both the Pakistan People's Party and Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party were running away as they had nothing to show with regard to their alleged foreign funding and money laundering. Claiming that Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz has conceded before the scrutiny committee of the Election Commission that it had received funds from slain Al-Qaeda terrorist Osama bin Laden, Habib said former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif laid the foundation of foreign funding in Pakistan by receiving funds to topple former Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto's government.
Ke aaj inke vakil is cheez ka itraaf karenge ke 90 ki dahai mein Osama bin Laden यानी कि जिसका जिक्र बेनजीर भुट्टो साहिबा की किताब के अंदर है कि नवाज शरीफ ने उसामा बिन लादन से फॉरेन फंडिंग लेकर उनकी हकूमत के खिलाफ अदम एतमाद लेकर आए 10 मिलियन डॉलर की रकम थी उस
He also criticized the Jamiat Ulema-Islam Fazl and said its chief Maulana Fazl-ur-Rahman had received funds from Libya and Iraq. A few days back, Pakistan's former envoy to the US, Abida Hussain, revealed that Osama bin Laden had supported and extended financial assistance to Nawaz Sharif. Sharif, who has been the Prime Minister of Pakistan for 3 non-consecutive terms, has been accused time and again of taking money from Osama bin Laden in order to promote and fund jihad in Kashmir. He was ousted from power in 2017 by the Supreme Court on corruption charges and is in London for medical treatment.
Moving on, locals in the illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir have expressed anger over rising inflation owing to Islamabad's incompetent policies. They blame the economic losses faced by Pakistan due to policy paralysis are compensated from regions under its illegal control.
A sharp rise in the fuel, food and transportation costs has severely hit the domestic budgets of people in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, who are facing immense difficulties due to the consistent increase in inflation. Pakistani authorities earlier this month increased the price of petrol and diesel by up to 2.70 and 2.88 rupees per litre. Residents said now a direct impact would be again witnessed on prices of essential commodities due to hike in fuel prices as they are transported via road.
So, zahir hai ki jab petroleum masnuhat badhti hain to tamam cheezon pe iska asar hota hai, wo transport ho, digar zaraye naqlo harkat ho.
Locals blame the economic losses being faced by Pakistan due to policy paralysis are compensated from regions under its illegal control. They accuse there has been no progress when it comes to employment and development of the region. However, they continue to be subjected to hardships.
The Pentagon has reiterated that any withdrawal from Afghanistan will be condition-based and that no decision has been made in this regard yet. Pentagon spokesman John Kirby, in a question about a possible increase in the number of US forces in Afghanistan on Wednesday, said that the US Defense Secretary is assessing all options, but said that the best solution to the conflict in Afghanistan is a political settlement of the conflict. Based on the US-Taliban peace deal signed last year, the then US President Donald Trump's administration pledged to withdraw all its forces from the war-torn Afghanistan by the end of May 2021. This comes as peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban are underway in Doha since September. However, no breakthrough has been achieved from the talks so far.
We are committed to a political settlement in Afghanistan, one that includes the Afghan government. As we've said many times, an Afghan-led, Afghan-owned peace process. And we're going to continue to support the achievement of a political settlement. No forced posture decisions have been made, and I wouldn't speculate beyond that.
More on news from Afghanistan. As rising violence in Afghanistan is raising concern among Afghans and international organizations, a senior European Union humanitarian official has said half of Afghans need humanitarian aid.
Half of Afghans need humanitarian aid, but rising violence is preventing deliveries, a senior European Union humanitarian official said on Wednesday, reiterating calls for a ceasefire between the Afghan government and the Taliban. The European Commissioner for Crisis Management, Yanis Lilarchich, visited Kabul to announce the EU will provide $38.5 million for humanitarian projects in 2021.
Humanitarian needs are rising globally and also in Afghanistan for various reasons, primarily because of the conflict. The violence, as we see, continues in the country, but also due to the pandemic of COVID-19 and other challenges, including the natural disasters that often affect this country.
Violence has risen in war-torn Afghanistan, dashing hopes that a U.S. brokered peace process in Doha would reduce conflict while the Afghan government and the Taliban negotiated a political settlement. Even during the usually subdued winter months, fighting has taken place around the country, along with a wave of assassinations of government officials and civil society members.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The rival faction of ruling Nepal Communist Party declared a nationwide strike on Thursday to ramp up opposition against Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli for dissolving the parliament and seeking fresh polls amid a pandemic-induced economic crisis. Streets in capital Kathmandu wore a deserted look with normal life affected. Arson and vandalism were also reported, forcing police to arrest the protesters.
Pushp Kamal Dehel and Madhav Kumar Nepal's faction of ruling Nepal Communist Party declared a nationwide strike on Thursday to ramp up opposition against Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli for dissolving the parliament and seeking fresh polls amid a pandemic-induced economic crisis. The call to shut down businesses, shops, educational institutions was part of a protest campaign launched across the Himalayan nation after Oli dissolved the parliament on December 20. Citing a lack of cooperation from other leaders of NCP. Protesters continued to march on capital Kathmandu streets on Thursday and some even clashed with police, resulting in their arrests. Reports of vandalism were also confirmed throughout the nation.
Okay, as Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli dissolved the parliament, we believe that his action was completely unconstitutional. The provision was, there was not any kind of provision which was related to the dissolvement of the parliament. So this was unconstitutional step. So we are against that unconstitutional step and we want the parliament to be restored. And that was the main motive for our protest.
Meanwhile, the decision of dissolution of parliament is being challenged in court, with over a dozen cases filed in Nepal Supreme Court whose verdicts are expected by the end of this month.
Indian Defence Minister Rajnath Singh, while expressing India's willingness to promote trade and tourism among Indian Ocean region countries on Thursday, said his country is ready to supply various types of missile systems, light combat aircraft and other weapon systems to its friendly foreign countries in the IOR, the Indian Ocean region. Singh made the remarks while speaking at the IOR Defence Minister's conclave in southern Bengaluru city, which was organised on the second day of Aero India 2021. The 13th edition of the three-day event began on Wednesday with a spectacular air show. This is the first aerospace and defence exhibition in the international calendar to take place post-COVID-19 and has drawn nearly 600 Indian and foreign aviation firms. Moving on, 28-year-old Usman Khan lives in an impoverished region of Pakistan. He normally sells children's toys from a roadside stand, but since the start of the pandemic, he has begun to dress up as Charlie Chaplin. And thanks to social media, he has become a bit of a celebrity. He vows to make people smile in trying times.
In the bustling northern Pakistani city of Peshawar, 28-year-old Usman Khan in bow tie, bowler hat and carrying a can flamboyantly weaves through busy traffic in a scene reminiscent of a 1920s silent film. Khan used to sell children's toys from a roadside stand, but during the COVID-19 pandemic has transformed himself into Charlie Chaplin, a century after the silent comedian was propelled to global fame with his slapstick antics. Khan dons the familiar costume of Chaplin's The Trap character. He takes to the streets, often accompanied by friends filming him, hoping to bring a bit of cheer in dreary times.
Charlie से मैं इसलिए मुतासिर हूँ कि उसका body language वो silent comedy से लोगों को मुस्कुराना ये बहुत बड़ी बात होती है. Silent comedy से लोगों का दिल जीतना ये काफी बहुत बड़ी बात होती है. तो मैंने कहा क्यों ना मैं भी Charlie Chaplin बनूँ पाकिस्तान के लिए ताकि ये कोरोना वबा का ये जो है ये भी एक साइड पर हो जाए लोग खुशी की तरफ आ जाए कॉमेडीज की तरफ आ जाए.
In just 2 months, he has gained more than 800,000 followers on the social media platform TikTok. People, he says, from around the globe who finds his comedy a welcome respite from the pandemic and its lockdowns and social distancing. Khan hopes film and television producers will notice him as well and says if he ever became wealthy, he would share his earnings with the poor.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.